Life, and we celebrate you today, Lord Jesus. Have your way in this place, oh God. We love you, we honor you, and we praise you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah. Yeah. One time. Nobody greater. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
praise today. Come on, just bless him. Is this Resurrection
Hallelujah!
Sunday?
Hallelujah!
Come on, give
Hallelujah!
God praise. I know God's not dead, but are y'all dead?
Hallelujah!
Come on, stand up and give God praise this morning.
Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Hey. 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 Woo.
Yeah. He's a wonder. 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 He's a wonder.
Go tell everybody in every nation, along with the angels, live believe he lives.
I'm sure he lives.
I'm sure he lives.
I'm sure he lives.
I'm sure he lives.
I know he lives.
I know he lives.
The Savior lives.
The Savior lives.
voice and celebrate. He lives. The Lord and Savior is no longer dead. Rejoice and celebrate. Jesus is alive. Woo! Feels good in this place today. Come on, everybody that would, just stand up on your feet. Everybody that can, you got two good feet, two good legs to stand up on. God has been too good for you to come into his house, for you to sit down on him. Come on, help us say. Come on, rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Somebody open your mouth and rejoice, rejoice. He's so much better than just a hand clap. Rejoice, rejoice. Woo! Hallelujah. 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 He lives. Y'all go ahead and sit down if you can. Hallelujah. Ah, today's a good day. Hallelujah. All of our first-time visitors, if you would, just wave your hands. First-time visitors, just lift your hands and wave, and we ain't going to embarrass you now. Just wave. We want to share some Potter's House love. Come on, keep waving till somebody hug you. Keep waving till somebody hug you. Come on, keep waving your hand till somebody hug you. Show some Potter's House love to our visitors. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We are so excited that you have come on this Resurrection Sunday to come and celebrate with us, to come and dine at the table with us here at the Potter's House Dayton International Ministries, where our friend, our spiritual father, is none other than the Bishop Mark C. McGuire, our Pura, our voice. Come on, we stand in the honor of the God in him. Come on, all the sons and daughters of Potter's House, you should be on your feet, giving God praise for the man of God. Come on, give God praise for the man of God. Hallelujah. Woo-hoo. I'm just anticipating something different for you today. Something wonderful for you today. We count it an honor, privilege, and a joy that you have come. At the end of service, we will take our offering. And we ask that no one would please leave before the benediction. It's that one good last time we get to say amen together. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We are excited about today. Anybody just come expecting something different? Something new? Come on, if you believe he got up, you can get up too. From every situation in your life, if you believe he got up with all power, can't help nobody in here. Amen. God is so good. We are just excited about what he's going to do on today through this ministry. We truly hope that you leave here different than the way you came in. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, if you would, right where you are, just bow your heads. Father, we honor you. We bless you. We magnify you. We glorify you, oh God. Today, God, we say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. You did it just for me. Thank you for the blood. Thank you, oh God. We worship you today. We ask even right now, God, that you would come into this place. Let your Holy Ghost just rest, rule, and abide. change the hearts, the minds of your people here today. God, we bless you. We honor you. We thank you. We are simply expecting and anticipating a great move from you today, God. We bless you. We honor you, oh God. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Every heart said amen. Wonder if I could just get about 10 of you all who come to just pour out to God your worship. If you would just stand and lift your hands to him and just begin to give him the fruit of your lips. Let him hear your voice. Come on, can you just lift your hands to him and just let him know how much you love him? How thankful you are. How grateful you are that he did not give up on you. Oh, how we love you. Oh, how we worship you. Our Lord. Come on, lift your hands to him. Let him hear your voice. Let him hear your voice.
Praise.
Oh, how we praise.
him, praise him, worship him. He's the Lord. He's the Lord. We love you, Jesus. 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 We praise 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 you, Jesus. We worship 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 you, Jesus. Oh God, I love you today, yes.
Oh, how we praise you.
Oh, I praise you.
Oh, how we worship.
How we worship you, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Oh, oh,
oh, how we love.
Oh God, I love you with all of my heart. Yes, I do.
Oh,
I know, I do.
Praise.
Oh God, I praise you in the sanctuary, yes.
Oh, how we worship.
Right now, I lift my hand and worship.
We were.
Come on, give God your best. Come on, give him your best. 5 seconds of your best. 10 people shout hallelujah. 10 people shout hallelujah. You may be seated. We have an exciting, exciting time in worshiping and celebrating the risen Savior this morning. Amen. Come on, touch 3 people and say, he got up, he got up, he got up. Amen. He died, but he surely got up. We serve the risen Savior, and we are excited about that. Amen. I know we're snuggled together. You've got some of your young ones in here with you. Amen. But it's all right. God is good. We're just going to have a good time in here. Who's anticipating a good time? Believing God's going to do something. Got a couple of announcements. We always want you to check the website. We always want you to be prepared for Sunday morning classes at 9. They are great. We also are looking forward to our men's conference at the end of the month. Amen. And so we want to get the word out. And shortly after that, the Daughter Summit, we will be hosting that. And so many of you will be excited. The ladies will be excited about that. So we're looking forward to that. Amen. And we'll do more of that on next week. And we've got some things that we normally do. And I know he's been running and working, and we've been praying for him. And we haven't had a time to celebrate him a little bit, but we want to do that today. Deshaun, stand up for us, man. Deshaun Gay is he's a 4-year letterman at Trotwood. He is part of the Great Western Ohio Conference, one of the all-area players for Trotwood. He's been in so many state tournaments with the football team. He's going on to pursue that career after high school. And one of the things that I love about him is that time and time again, he's been on that dean's list. Amen. And so we thank God for him. He's been a part of Young Life. And so we salute you, man, as a good soldier. Amen. I wanted to do that in front of our entire family today. We salute you. Graduating this year, and we're just excited for what God's going to do for your life. Amen. Amen. So we're going to be praying for him. Amen. And the others that are going on to school, we'll do that in fall. But I just wanted to do that. I wanted to make sure that we did that soon, because we sometimes we don't celebrate our young people. Amen. And but the thing that I love most is that I text him every now and then and just tell him to be a light, just, you know, show forth Christ to the team. And he would text back and said, I'm praying with the guys. Amen. And so that's what it was really about, being a light, being able to pray with the teammates and letting them know that Jesus is real. Amen. And so a lot of times star athletes, good looking kids, they're worried about their image when it comes to Christ. And so I just was so proud of him being willing to step out there and say, Jesus is the reason. Amen. And so we celebrate that one more time. Just celebrate God. Amen. I'm always inspired by that. Out of all the years of loving Jesus, I didn't do that. Nobody pushed me to do that. Nobody pushed me to witness. They pushed me to Sunday school and they pushed me to church, but nobody pushed me to witness. Amen. And so when I see young people who are doing well and they witness in this day and age, that's courage. Amen. Amen. That's courage. That's more courage than a gangbanger. Amen. To lift up Jesus in this river generation. It's just kind of crazy. We have just an untoward generation. And so, but God is good. Amen. One thing I also want to invite the family is that we have a powerful youth mission here called Young Life for teens. And it has been blessing so many people and doing such a great job in the community. We're represented in about 14 Dayton public schools. And we're thankful for what God has done with Young Life and the Young Life leaders. And they're awesome. And they do a great work. And we invite anyone on a Monday night to just come and see what we do and see if you want to be a part of what we do. But on May the 16th, we've got a banquet, and we want to invite everyone. We've got people coming from around the country, and then so many people from around the Dayton metropolitan area. And we want to invite you. There's information at the Inspiration Station in the back, and there are invitations and RSVPs, and then also I'm going to ask that if you get, who in here, what woman in here gets your hair done at the beauty shop? Now raise your hand now. Don't be acting like that. Where Tanya Macklin at? I know Tanya. Tanya, you get your hair done at the beauty shop? No? Yes? Well, raise your hand. Set a standard for me. All right. I want you to make sure that you take one of these ad forms. It's very cheap to your beauty salon, the people that keep you dude up and whipped up, and make sure that they get an opportunity. All the fellas that go to the barbershop, raise your hand. Y'all, some of y'all lying. Y'all just lying. I can't believe that. Y'all just lying. Now, if I was saying I was giving out money, y'all hands would be up. I want you to take this to the beauty salon, the barbershops, and just make sure that they get a chance to be a part of what we're doing. All that information is in the back. I needed to announce that. Also, I believe baptism is April 26th, and you'll get more information about that. If you've never been baptized and you're ready to be baptized and you want to be dipped, amen, we'll do that on April the 26th, but you'll get more information about that. I am just excited about Easter Sunday. You all just don't know. I am always excited about Resurrection Sunday. And so at the end of service today, we will take communion together, all those that desire it. And I look forward to that. It won't belong the hour too long, or prolong the hour too long. But we're excited to do that. All right? Are we ready for a small family greeting? I see everybody moving. All right? I'm going to move on your cue. Amen. Bring it in low, and then I'll say what I need to say, and then turn it up, and then take it down easy. All right? Hug three or four people. Tell them that you love them. All right? Stretch out. We're getting ready to be blessed. But in the meantime, tell some folk you don't know, Happy Easter. Just touch somebody and hug them. Just hug them. Come on. Some of y'all used to the club. Don't worry about it. Come on. Tell them. Say, I'm glad to see you, girl. You're looking good, man. Happy Easter to you. Happy Resurrection Sunday.
Yeah. know you want it. But if you wanna get what you never got, gotta do something that you never started.
Awful, brutal death was experienced there on the cross. The death Christ died was one of absolute torture. You and I cannot even begin to imagine all the pain that Jesus endured for our sake. Allow us to refresh your mind about the terrible price Jesus paid for you as he suffered for sin that day.
Thank you.
There is forgiveness for you at the cross. There is salvation for you at the cross. There is love for you at his cross. There is atonement for you at the cross. Jesus suffered for you at the cross. Jesus was our victor over sin at the cross. There is eternal security for you at the cross.
Oh! resurrection. And now I am free.
Yet in weakness, while we were yet powerless to help ourselves, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. But God demonstrated his own love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Thank you. nation, baptizing them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Teach them to observe all things whatsoever I command you today. And lo, I will be with you even until the very end. His message.
Hallelujah.
His cross.
be my Jesus. They beat him all night long, you say then, until they shivered every little bone. Oh, 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 oh. And when he took his very last breath, he hung his head and died for you and I. Oh, what love the man has for me. Thank you, Jesus, that he would give his love. Help me sing,
oh, what love
he has for me.
Has for me.
That he would
give
his love.
Come on, celebrate the love. Come on, celebrate the love. Can't nobody love you like Jesus. Come on, we have some love leave us, but Jesus, oh, what love. Oh, what love he has for me. Look at somebody and say, for me. Did he know about me? The love he had for me. Look at somebody and say, he had love for you. Just for us. Oh, what love. This is why we can lift our hands and worship him. This is why we can clap our hands and praise him. This is why we open up our mouths and tell the Lord, thank you. The world may look at us strange. And it's amazing that out of the whole year, we see Jesus everywhere in this particular season. I don't know about you, but before and even during my time of salvation, there were some things that I needed to let go. There was some problems, some situations, some people, some stuff and things that I needed to let go. There's an old hymn that says, at the cross, where I first saw the light and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I receive my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Perhaps there's someone here. You came just out of tradition, but you didn't just come to a service, you came for salvation. You came to spectate, but you encountered Christ. You came to spy out what was happening, but instead you felt God move. Perhaps you're dealing with something and you've called on every name. You called mama, you called daddy, you called brother, you called sister, you called boo. And they let you down. But today, if there's anything that you may be dealing with, that you may be dealing with, the song simply says, meet me here at the cross.
Meet me here. Meet me here.
Meet me.
Meet me here.
At the cross.
At the cross.
Meet me here. Just think about it. I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
And I let it go.
I let it go.
I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all to you.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down. Go.
I let it go.
Come on, meet me here.
Meet me here.
Come on, just begin to
meet me here.
Think about that thing you need to let go.
Meet me here.
Jesus is saying, meet him here
at the cross,
where he took on all
meet me
the sins of the world. Saying, meet me here.
Meet me here.
At the cross.
At the cross.
Come on, tell them, I surrender. Can you just lift your hands and say, I surrender?
I surrender.
I give it all to you.
I give it all to you.
Lay it down.
I lay it down.
I let it go. I let it go.
I let it go.
Come on, say it again. I surrender. Say, I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
Lay it down.
I lay it down.
I let it go. I let it go.
I let it go.
I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
I let it go. Surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
I let it go. I let it go.
I let it go.
Come on, tell them. Tell them. I surrender. I surrender. If that's you,
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
Yeah. Let it go.
Let it go.
Come on, come on. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
Yes, I let it go. I let it go.
I let it go.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, one more time. Tell them, I surrender. I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all. I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
Yeah, yeah. I let it go. I let it go.
I let it go.
Come on, come on. Tell them again. I surrender. I surrender.
I surrender.
I give it all.
I give it all to you.
I lay it down.
I lay it down.
Entire story today that was given to us by this worship and arts team, it culminates in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 1 through 4. It says, "Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also you have received and wherein you stand, by which also you are saved, if you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless you have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sin according to the scriptures." And so it was that the scriptures that we've read and the scriptures that we know is that he was beaten. Crown of thorns was placed upon his head. He was dragged up a road to Golgotha's hill. Nails were put in his hands and his feet. He hung there on the cross. He said those seven last words that you saw, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And to the thief on his right that said, "Take me with you," he said, "Today you shall be with me in paradise." And then in agony, and while he was asphyxiating and while he was unable to breathe and his shoulders were cramping and coming dislodged, he looked out and saw his mother standing there next to the disciple named John. And he said, "Mother, behold thy son, and son, behold thy mother." And so he was there and still hanging and fulfilling all that was in the law, taking on all the sins of the world, trying to figure out how he was going to survive this cross in his flesh, but yet in his spirit, knowing that he was dying for you and for me. But in that moment, he knew that God's eternal love for us meant a moment of rejection for him. And so he cried out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And so it was that he laid there in the pain, excruciating. He shouted out, "I thirst." And they tried to give him sour wine, but he refused it. And so looking back over his 33 years and looking back over thousands of years of history, of the law of Moses, every sacrifice and every offering that God had commanded them to give, But the Hebrew writer said that in none of those sacrifices was God satisfied. But he prepared a body in the person of Jesus Christ that would fulfill all the sacrifices and that would take away all of our sins. Everything you've ever thought, everything you've ever done, every wrong we've ever committed, not only in our past, but our present, and even in our future, someone had to die. Because God said the wages of sin is death. And the one thing about God is he never changes his mind. The reward for our sin is still death. The reward for our disobedience is still death. God has not changed his law. But what he did, he gave us a man named Jesus who died on our behalf. And the Bible says that he did it once and for all. And that's why we love him. That's why we worship him. Because without that death, you and I would not be here today. And so in that moment of looking back and recognizing that everything had been accomplished, he shouted out, "It is finished." The law and the ordinances that were written against us, the law came as a schoolmaster, as a teacher, to show us what we couldn't do to live up to the standards of a holy God. But God in his love, that great scripture, John 3:16, "For he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." God just wants us to have faith in the finished work of Jesus Christ. And with that being said, he looked up to heaven and said, "Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit." And so for us, those seven last words mean everything to us. Because he died and he shed his blood for our sins. And then the Bible teaches us that he went down and he took back the keys of death, hell, and the grave. And he came up with all power in his hand. And on Friday, we celebrated his crucifixion. On Saturday, we rest in the finished work of Christ. But on Sunday, we shout victory. Because whatever you needed to die, it died on Friday night. And everything that you need to raise up, it raised up this morning. All of your pain can be gone. All of your shame can be gone. All of your guilt can be gone. And now you can live with joy and with purpose and with destiny and with healing. And he did it just for you. He did it for all of us, but just for you. He knows and has counted, and he knows the number of every hair on your head. There is nothing about you that God is not already acquainted with, and he loved you anyway. That's good news, that he loved us anyway. Somebody say anyway. In spite of who we are, in spite of who we've been. And all he wants is our love. All he wants is us to have faith in who he is. And here's the great part. Grace comes. With your faith in Christ Jesus, grace comes. Somebody say grace comes. Because without grace, we can't obey him. Without grace, we can't live right for him. Without grace, we're not convicted when we go opposite of him. Without grace, we don't recognize and understand who he is. But grace comes. Somebody say grace comes. And he doesn't give grace because you're great. He gives you grace because you need it. He gives you grace because without this grace, you can't love each other. Without this grace, you can't fulfill your purpose. Without this grace, there's no revelation of your destiny. And more importantly, the love that God has for you. In the book of John, chapter 20. Starting with verse 11, it says, But Mary stood without at the sepulchre weeping. And as she wept, she stooped down and looked in. And see of two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why are you weeping? And she says to them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. And when she had said thus, or had thus said, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing. And she knew not that it was Jesus. Then Jesus said to her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? In one translation, it just says, Woman, why are you crying? And what is it that you're looking for? That's the question that God is asking us today. Man, woman, why are you crying? Why are you living in such desperation? Why are you living beneath what I've already paid for you? Why are you allowing the enemy to take what I've already given into your life? What is it that you're looking for? But most of us, just like Mary, with him right in front of us, are living with blinded eyes. But here's the love of God, recognizing that we need another dimension, another revelation of his love. He transitions his love from calling her woman to saying Mary. God's calling somebody's name today. He is speaking directly to you today. You can't give up this moment. There's no point of the cross and the resurrection if we don't receive him. You're in here today. As a family, in a moment, we'll take communion. But you're in here today. And if you're in here right now, and you can sense and you can feel that God is calling your name, and that you want some stuff to die in your life, and you need some stuff to come alive, if you need to recommit, if you need to come back to God because you've let it kind of slip away from the forefront of your faith, if you need to learn to trust him again, God's calling your name. And you can step out of those pews right now and come and receive Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. He's calling your name right now. If that's you, I want you to come forward right now. Don't wait another minute. Don't allow the enemy to hold you back another second. God's calling your name, and you're not by yourself. Hear God calling your name. You want a new life. You want a life of purpose. You want a life of destiny. You want that power that Jesus showed when he raised again from the dead. You want resurrection power alive in your life. You want this like never before. Jesus said, I thirst. What was he thirsting for? Righteousness. What was he hungering for? The kingdom of God. Listen, Jesus said, Fear not, little flock. It is the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. God wants you to have everything that he paid the price for. That's your joy, your peace. Listen, even your physical healing. It's a covenant promise and privilege that believers have. But more than anything, you get to have eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Listen, here's the truth of the matter. Our soul is eternal. Once you were born, your soul is eternal. And you either will live in eternity with God, or your soul will suffer a burning, dying hell for eternity. And the thing about hell is just like the devil, it never stops. You don't just die, feel burning, and then it's over. It burns over and over and over and over again. But Jesus said, I've come that in your spirit you might be able to cry for the rest of eternity in the presence of an almighty God, holy, 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 the Lord God Almighty. Change, it comes in our faith in Jesus Christ. The grace of God, listen, everybody wants power, but there's no power like resurrection power. Watch what Jesus did. He died. One of my buddies, he raps and he hit me on a text, and he was just reminding me of the gospel. He said, my bishop, peep this. God died, and then he raised himself up. He said, man, that's turned up for real. And if God can die and then raise himself up from the grave, you don't have anything that he can't raise up to the place where he desire it. You don't have anything that you're going through that God can't fix while he's sitting beside the right hand of the Father. There's nothing that Jesus can't do for you if he rose himself up from the grave. That's real talk. There's days I can't even raise myself out of bed, and I've got everything working. I'm breathing. Alarm clocks. Still can't move, but God. And the Bible says, here's where the devil gets most of us, because we think we're too shameful, or we've had too bad of a life, or we've messed up too much, or we got saved and we went back and we can't get back. But the Bible says he's rich in mercy.
Yes, yes.
It doesn't run out. He doesn't give out cards and then he's looking to try to get more. He's got enough mercy for everybody. And even though it's a corporate relationship, it's an individual relationship. He doesn't just care about the church. He cares about you. He doesn't just care about the world. He cares about you and what you're going through. And there's nothing too small or nothing too big. And today your decision is, I want to walk with God in a new dimension, in a new fervor, in a new extreme demonstration of power. And then guess what God's going to do for you? I just got to prophesy. God's not only going to give you your purpose back, but he's going to give you power. You're going to lay hands on the sick. That you're going to speak with new tongues. That you're going to be the light and the salt of the earth. That you're going to proclaim and preach the gospel. And wherever it is that God sends you, school, work, in your neighborhood, your family, you're going to tell somebody of the good news. Next year, you'll be bringing people to Easter service because you know they need the risen Savior. Now he is going to take himself by way of the Holy Spirit and sit down on the inside of you, on the throne of your heart. He wants to use you. He didn't come today by accident. Came on purpose. And the Bible simply says in Romans 10:9 that if you'll believe in your heart, confess with your mouth, and believe in your heart, your confession is that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God. What you believe in your heart is that he died and God raised him from the dead. And the Bible says you shall be saved.
Yes, yes.
Salvation is right there, the Bible says. It's in your mouth. And so I'm going to pray a prayer, and then I'm going to ask you to say something, and you're going to say it from your heart, and you're going to say it to God, and you're going to believe that Jesus died for your sins, as you saw here, and this red that was all over him means that he shed his blood. And when he shed his blood was payment for ransom. See, the deal is, while you were living this world, you were a hostage by the devil. He had you hostage, tied up, couldn't move, putting on you whatever he wanted to. Grief, despair, shame. But now God's loosing you from that. He's paying your ransom with his blood. So Father, we thank you right now. We glorify you right now. Let us sit right there in the front row. We're glorifying you right now. We're magnifying for your death, God. You died for us. In order for there to be an inheritance, there must be a death. And so we inherit the kingdom. We're joint heirs with Christ because you died. We thank you that proof was in your burial, God. That you were there, but then you were gone. On that third morning, God, there was a quake and a shifting of everything that entrapped us. And when those ladies looked in, you had raised yourself from the dead. And so, God, we apply this gospel to everyone that's on this altar. If it's their first time, if it's a rededication, if it's a recommitment to your love and your grace and your power, if it is just a rededication to your work and your calling, or if it is a coming forward for your original salvation, God, we pray that you would receive them now through the blood of Jesus Christ. For Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Now, God, you said in your word that if we would receive you, that you would give us the power to be the children of God, true sons and daughters, operating with your grace, sealed by your Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, in union with the Father and with the blood of Jesus Christ, you promised to seal our salvation and be the earnest of our expectation, the down payment of our promise to heaven. And so you promised that we would get a taste of heaven right here on earth, a down payment of healing and joy and peace and love and long-suffering and gentleness and kindness, temperance and meekness. Against such, we could never be taken hostage again. So we receive your gift of salvation, God. We receive Jesus Christ into our lives. And together we will repeat these words. I confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. I believe in my heart that he lived, never sinned, died for doing nothing wrong, taking my sins, grief, and pain to the cross for me. He was rejected and forsaken in one moment by the Father, because God will never forsake me or leave me. And on the third day, he raised up with all power in his hand. And now my old man is dead, and my new man is resurrected. I am a new person in Christ. Old things are passed away. All things have become new. I'm saved. I'm free. I'm delivered. I'm his. Hallelujah. Say, I'm saved. Say, I'm back. Say, I'm recommitted. I'm rededicated. I love Jesus, and he loves me. Come on, give God some praise. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. Receive ye the Holy Spirit. Receive ye the Holy Spirit. Receive ye the outpouring of His Spirit in great measure. In great measure. While you're going to your seats, we're going to prepare for communion. I want our ushers, let's get ready to give, and then we'll give communion and give benediction and go home. Somebody say, I'm ready. To give an offering, just like He offered for me. God wants us to do our best. Now listen, everyone that just got saved for the very first time, if you're here and you got saved for the very first time, I want you to look toward the front. Stand up. This young lady at the end of service will be walking up those stairs, and I want you to follow her up those stairs if you got saved for the very first time. Amen. Come on, everybody, put their hands together. We welcome you into the kingdom of God. For everybody that rededicated and recommitted your life to Christ, you just draw a line in the sand and forget about what was behind you, and you press toward the mark of the high call of Jesus Christ. Don't you worry about how your life used to be. You just move in the glory of God and begin to let God's power and His Spirit guide you. All right? So this is the time that we give. This is the time that we love back on God. This is the time that we appreciate what God has done for us. And they're going to sing us something that's going to help us feel good about celebrating God with our tithe and our offering. In Jesus' name. Father, bless it. Increase it. Cause it to multiply. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, you can dance if you want to right there in your seat. You can stand. You can shout. Because whatever you sow, you shall also reap. And you can never beat God giving. And so your obedience and giving will unlock the promises of God in your life. Hallelujah. If you need a communion element, raise your hand. If you need a communion element, raise your hand. We're going to put those words back on the screen. It looked like we weren't in sync. We're going to put those words back on the sing so every on the screen so everybody can sing that together as we're giving. He lives. Come on. My Lord and Savior is no longer dead. Celebrate. He lives, he lives. Come Come on, y'all, sing it.
He lives.
Come on, all your heart, come on.
Right in prison, just like he said.
Come on.
The Lord is Savior, no longer dead. Rejoice and celebrate. He lives, Jesus is alive. He lives. Right in prison, just like he said. The Lord is Savior, no longer dead.
Somebody say he lives. Okay, let's break it down. We're going to switch shift gears here. We're almost done with our offering. And just kind of simultaneously, so we're not here longer than we have to. I want to turn to Matthew's Gospel, chapter 26. And we'll look at, start at verse 26, and I'm going to read that. It was time for the Passover meal, and Jesus sent men into the city, and he said, there'll be a man with a pitcher of water in his hand. Follow that man and tell him you have need of a room in his house. And go prepare for this meal. And so they did that. And they ate together, and then Jesus had them all turn, and he took off of his girdle and he began to wash their feet, and he began to take care of the dirt that was on them. And Peter, assuming to have the right word, said, no, Lord, I'm not worthy for you to wash my feet. And Jesus said that if I don't wash your feet, you have no part of me. And so Peter said, then wash all of me from my head down to my toes. And as Jesus finished the washing of the disciples' feet, he began to talk about a moment of betrayal, and that this night would come and bring offense to many. And so back at the table, he instituted what we know as the Lord's Supper. And he said that there will be one that would be here that as I dip with you all, that with you 12, that one would betray me. And they all became sorrowful because inside of themselves they knew that there were sometimes some doubt and some fear. And we all deal with that sometimes. But he began to dip, and then finally he gave to Judas Iscariot, and he said, now go quickly and do what it is that you're supposed to do. And we know the story. Judas went and he got with the high priest, and they gave him 30 shekels of silver. Silver being the color for redemption. 30 being the number for priesthood and maturity. And it was time for redemption had matured. The time had come. And so many of the disciples, though, before Judas had left, they asked themselves and asked Christ, is it me that's going to do you wrong? And Jesus just allowed the night to continue. But before it was over, it says, and as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. This means that God, because of your faith in Jesus Christ, and because of your remembrance of his death on Calvary, and your confession and repentance and real love for him, he will not hold these sins against you and cause you to receive the death of a burning hell. But verse 29 says, but I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. God then was giving a promise to his disciples that he would see them again in the kingdom of God, that there would be a marriage supper where they would be around the table once again. This table is going to be large. This table is going to be huge, because it won't just be the 12 apostles, but it'll be the family of God at the supper table with the Lord of glory. And so it is that we take communion, the Eucharist, the Lord's Supper. We do this together as a family in remembrance of him. And Paul said, as often as you do this remembering the Lord's death until he comes. Jesus died for you. If you got saved today or you've been saved, Jesus died for you. He shed his blood for you. The Bible says he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. And by his stripes, we were healed. Mentally, physically, emotionally, socially, relationally, and even financially. God has come to bring healing to us. In the Chronicles, it simply said, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and then will I heal their land, and my eyes shall be open and my ears attentive to the prayers that they shall make in this place. I believe if we turn our hearts to God now, forgive those that we may have ought against, and look for an opportunity to apologize to anyone that might have ought against us. We desire to live the life that God has for us. We desire to walk in the purpose that God died and rose again from the dead for. I believe that the best for you is yet to come. And so as it was on that night, he blessed it, and then they ate and they drank together. So, Father, we bless you. We thank you. We honor you. And God, even as we leave this place, but as it is, not your presence, for you said you'll never leave us nor forsake us, let us leave in celebration. Let us leave in expectation. Let us leave in joy that you died, but you rose again from the dead. And the same power that raised you from the dead, we now operate in the earth. We love you, sir. We honor you. And we give ourselves to you today in Jesus' name. Protect all of us as we leave this place, not only from hurt, harm, and danger, but from the mindset and the manipulation of the enemy, that what we did today was real and there's nothing the devil can do about it. Help us to love each other as we love ourselves, and ultimately, we love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Happy Easter. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, happy Resurrection Sunday. Amen. You be blessed. Happy birthday to Donna and to others. God bless you. We love you. We'll see you next Sunday. Enjoy your day. Enjoy your week. Be safe. Be careful. Can I get a round of applause?